likes their depth, and when you play their style, you've got to have guys off your bench who can contribute.
Great crowd on hand for opening night in the ACC. We are underway in Raleigh. NC State controls the tip.
And Georgia Tech starts in their zone. It's a matchup zone. It kind of looks like a... I take that back. They're in a man. Showing a man-to-man early. Played a lot of zone. The bulk of their defense last year.
And it's a zone that has stifled this NC State team in the last two meetings. Five to shoot on the opening possession. CJ Bryce, pull up, pop, offensive board. Devin Daniels, he can't cash in. And finally, Georgia Tech corrals the rebound. Here's Jose Alvarado. This entire Yellow Jackets offense runs through number 10 in goal.
And Beverly matched up against him with Johnson out. That's a key matchup for NC State.
Go inside. Kick out. Moses Wright thought about a three. Five to shoot. Inside to right, the Raleigh native with one on the timer. Has to get rid of it. Wasn't aware of the shot clock. And NC State, great defense on their opening possession.
Last year, Georgia Tech turned the ball over on 21% of their possessions. 316th in the country. And when you're so deliberate offensively in that Princeton style, again, there's not a whole lot of possessions in a game where you could just give it away.
A makeshift starting lineup for the Wolfpack tonight with Markel Johnson out with an injury and DJ Thunderbird out with a suspension. Manny Bates, the redshirt freshman, tries but can't connect.
And Georgia Tech in a zone there, so it'll be interesting to see how they do that balance defensively.
Manny Bates, a big rejection on James Banks inside. And a foul call comes after.
This is what Manny Bates does. The redshirt freshman, 6'11", an outstanding shot blocker. And really a dimension they have not had, and I think particularly in their pressing defense, to have that on the back end, a shot blocker like Bates, it's a big deal.
How about it? The grad transfer from Lehigh opens the scoring. Pat Andre with a triple. And on the other end, he gets the steal. That is some debut for Pat Andre.
Devin Keats told us yesterday he thinks he's got a better shooting team this year, and this is a big reason why. The transfer from Lehigh, going to play that forward position for them. If you remember last year, Torin Dorn, much more of a driver, a slasher, not really a perimeter shooter. Andre gives them that dimension.
Shot 42% from three a year ago, but that was in the Patriot League. Now going against an ACC defense, and he drills the first shot he takes and then gets the steal on the other end. Here's Beverly at three. It's good!
And that's what he does. Three quarters of his shots last year were threes. He is hunting that three-point shot, and what a block there.
Manny Bates, his second rejection of the opening minutes, has brought this crowd to life in the opener. Now looking for Bates inside. Look out! Manny Bates on a wreck attack! Foul called, and that'll quiet this Wolfpack crowd. But talk about a great start to get your crowd into it on the opener.
Manny Bates has only played a handful of games over the last 2 years. There's the Beverly three. And then here is up top Manny Bates. How about the start he's had? Two monster blocks defensively. And then you give him a little sugar on the other end with a nice little lob pass, and what a finish. by Manny Bates.
He was forced to redshirt a year ago with a shoulder injury. Missed most of his senior year in high school with that same shoulder. So it's been a long time since he stepped on a competitive basketball court. No rust at all. Georgia Tech, a slam much needed to stop the bleeding early.
Well, what's interesting for NC State is they're playing without DJ Funderburk, who is suspended. And I think if you're Kevin Keats, he didn't want to have to throw Manny Bates into the fire and play a lot of minutes early. But here he is in the starting lineup, and what a start.
Rims out for Braxton Beverly. Georgia Tech looks to run. DeVoe thought about it. Inside, here's Banks, dumps it off. And another rim rocker. Moses Wright, the Raleigh native. And Georgia Tech has back-to-back buckets after an NC State 8-0 run to start the game. Here's C.J. Bryce. Andre again for three. Can't connect, but a foul called. Andre with three foul shots. When we come back, NC State up early, 8-4. ACC Network basketball is presented by Geico. 15 minutes could save you 15% or more on car insurance. Alongside Chris Patola, I'm Jay Alter here at PNC Arena. And the Wolfpack off to a great start, opened up on an 8-0 run. And NC State without Markel Johnson, without DJ Funderburk, arguably the two best players of this team, but it's the two guys, Manny Bates and Pat Andre, that subbed into that makeshift starting lineup. That had such a great start to this game, and now Andre heads the line for three foul shots.
You know, what a story Pat Andre is, a transfer from Lehigh. He went into his coach at Lehigh, Brett Reed, and said he wanted to do a grad transfer year somewhere else. He finished the transfer paperwork at 8:30 in the morning. By the end of the day, he had heard from 75 schools, and the last call of the day was from Kevin Keats and NC State. And here he is. And, you know, look, this is a team that shot 32% from three last year. They already have two made threes in this game, and Andre standing at the line shooting three free throws.
And he makes all three of them. Andre off to a quick 6 points. What made him so desirable?
Well, look, he does have pretty decent size. I mean, he's about 6'8". He does go about 220, but he's a face-up shooter. I mean, Kevin Keats says he's as good a shooter as I've seen in a long time. I mean, he had a game at Lehigh. He made 10 threes in a game. That's how good a face-up shooter Pat Andre is.
Michael DeVoe steps into a three and hits it. But NC State experimenting with the lineup early. You have Danny Dixon and Jericho Hellams who have checked into the game. Here's Hellams, a sophomore.
You know, Kevin Keats saying today, last year in that game against Georgia Tech, their perimeter shot 5 of 27 from 3. Against this zone, it's a 2-3 zone, you're going to get open looks. You've got to knock them down.
You have two really contrasting styles. Georgia Tech, who defensively plays that 2-3 zone. And then NC State tries to speed you up with that full court pressure. Rims out, second effort is good from DeVoe.
Michael DeVoe played very well on Georgia Tech's trip to Spain this summer. They're expecting big things from him this year.
Hellams count it, plus the foul.
You can't foul a face-up shooter. I mean, that's now two. They fouled Andre on the three, and then there. You're just closing out too hard. And that's not a guy that you have to close out. You could close out short on Jericho Hellams, and just two mental mistakes sending guys to the foul line.
Completes the three-point play. And this has been a perfect start for Kevin Keats at NC State, especially when you consider they're missing Markel Johnson.
And Funderburk.
Right.
I mean, you have to throw him in there. He is a big boy. He's gained about 20 pounds. When he gets back, he is going to make a major impact.
And Georgia Tech is all out of sorts early in this game. Third turnover already. J. Josh Pastner and the Yellow Jackets, they've done well against NC State, but the recipe has been not letting the Wolfpack play their game, which is speed it up, and already 16 points, a little more than 5 minutes into this game. Not the recipe to beat this team. This is Danny Dixon working at the post. Hook shot is good.
Another grad transfer from UM Kansas City, not known for his scoring.
Underneath, Evan Cole can't apply the finishing touch. Andre again. Hits it! Pat Andre already up to 9 points for the Wolfpack. Now I know why 75 teams were after his signature.
Well, here's the Dixon hook. And this is not what he is known for, but fundamental there. And then how about this? I mean, you got to find this guy. And to be honest, that defense wasn't bad. I mean, that's a hard closeout. And that's just a guy who's feeling it in his first game at NC State.
The best three-point shooter to come out of the Patriot League since Chris McCall.
Oh, easy there. Now. Easy there. No, he is a superior shooter, and that's what he does. Now, the question, as you said earlier, that Kevin Keats has had is, can he defend at this level? Can he physically hold up as an ACC player?
Inside, poked away. Devin Daniels pushes the tempo. Another three, Helms. Can't connect. Offensive board, C.J. Bryce. Swatted away. Alvarado trying to get Georgia Tech into it. Rattles in. Much needed three from Jose Alvarado.
This guy did not shoot it well last year, but shot it well as a freshman. So he's capable. And he worked on it so much over the summer, as he was telling us earlier today.
This team goes as Alvarado goes, so they need a big performance from the junior out of Brooklyn.
I always say the Princeton offense is not designed to get backdoor layups, although that's what everybody thinks. The Princeton offense is to get slow, undersized teams jump shots. Now, Georgia Tech's not slow and undersized, but that's what that offense is designed to do. It's designed to get face-up shots. Last year, Georgia Tech made 94 threes as a team. For context, Cam Johnson alone made 96.
Wow.
So, I mean, that's how good Cam Johnson is, but it's also how poorly Georgia Tech shot it last year.
You know, Josh Pastner spoke about it. They need to be better than 30% from three to compete in the ACC. Right now, struggling with Manny Bates inside. Redshirt freshman can't get the finish. In foul called against Bates, working against the senior James Banks. It's going to be a fascinating matchup to watch over the course of the night. You have Banks, one of the best big men in the ACC, going against a kid who's making his NC State debut. Right back to Banks. Surprised they haven't gone to that matchup more, Banks on Bates. And that, trying to get it to the senior, but overthrows Banks.
Well, they just can't get into a rhythm because they're turning it over. I mean, you know, and that's just a careless turnover by Alvarado. Banks wasn't open, and that's, you know, it's leading to points on the other end. NC State 5 points off of these turnovers.
Andre from deep. Why not? Pat Andre has come out on fire. 12 of the Wolfpack's 24 in this game. Here's Banks working on Bates inside. Dishes it off. Asante Price can't knock down the three.
With all due respect to the Weather Girls, it's not raining men here. It is raining threes. And they're coming from Pat Andre in his debut in an NC State uniform. It's raining threes.
Georgia Tech, the star guard, out with a left ankle injury, but his teammates have picked up the slack.
Yes, they have. That guy in particular, Pat Andre, 3 of 3 from three. The team 4 of 6. Braxton Beverly with that other one. Tell you what, makes your offense look real good when you come out shooting the ball from the perimeter like that.
The Lehigh transfer has not missed. Dishes it off there. 3 threes and then 3 foul shots as well. Gives them 12 points. Manny Bates having quite the debut. Can't get the finish there. On the other end, though, his third block of this first half. Manny Bates is everywhere. So for two guys in their first game in a Wolfpack uniform, you could not ask for much more. Beverly on the drive. Floater is good.
What a drive that was. Used the body to create the space to go up. Nice drive there by Braxton Beverly.
It feels weird to say, but you wouldn't even notice NC State was missing Markel Johnson, who's been their star guy the last couple of years. Banks off the mark. Helms for three. Way too much on that one from the sophomore. So Georgia Tech has struggled offensively. What can they do to get back in this game before halftime?
Well, not turn it over. Again, they've got 5 turnovers, and that's a good start. Is hitting that roll and forcing, you know, Manny Bates in this game, forcing him to at least defend. You know, he's got the 3 blocks, as you said. He's also got an early foul. I mean, they just haven't executed. The turnovers haven't helped. They haven't really gotten anything off of their Princeton stuff. Jose Alvarado not in the game.
Instead, it's Bubba Parham. Dishes off there. Open three for the freshman, Price. Misfiring. They've got some good looks earlier this first half. The difference is NC State has knocked him down. Georgia Tech has not. And it's a 12-point Wolfpack lead. Price, step back. Hits it.
I mean, it's everyone. Everyone has caught fire. What a move there. An individual move by C.J. Bryce on the step back.
Alvarado has been at that scorer's table for some time. Georgia Tech without their leading scorer, floor general. Moses Wright lost the handle. Battle for the ball. And a jump ball is the call.
There's this move on the other end by C.J. Bryce going to that right hand, and then he's got that step back that it seems everybody has in their game now. And he's a guy who's going to take a step, C.J. Bryce. Kevin Keats saying that he's back to being a three-level scorer. He went away from that three a little bit last year when he just wasn't shooting it at a high percentage. But I think he's poised for a really good year. He's there, you know, at the shoot-around today. I think he's their loudest voice. Certainly in practice.
Now there's 4 seconds on the shot clock following the jump ball call. Georgia Tech will have the inbound under the rim. Need a quick look here. They go to Moses Wright. Double team. Gets a shot out. Second effort not good. Wright a third time goes up for it. It gets it plus the foul. How about that? Moses Wright, who went to high school 6 miles away from the NC State campus, finally gets it to go.
That's a big front line. Moses Wright, 6'9", James Banks, 6'10". Both those guys doing work, keeping that ball alive. And as you say, Moses Wright came down with it. Had a really good night in that game against NC State last year at 18 points. He was very good at the tail end of their season.
And he said it was because he was home in Raleigh that really motivated him in that game. Ended up following it up at the ACC tournament with a 25-point performance against Notre Dame.
Nice
deep shot. Alvarado, touchdown at 2 points.
What a pass by Parham to find the streaking Alvarado. They don't run a lot, but Georgia Tech will be opportunistic.
Andre looking inside, ripped away. Best spell of possession for Georgia Tech so far tonight. Parham straight to the rack. Out to Alvarado for three. Too much on it. Daniels working on Alvarado. Banks got a piece of it. Dixon fouled on his way to the rim. We'll step aside. A fun night, college basketball. We welcome you back to ACC Network Basketball, presented by Geico. NC State up by 10 on the Yellow Jackets. Josh Pastner in Georgia Tech coming into the season. Some off-the-court issues to deal with. And it's tough always when you're starting a new season, new group of guys, but especially when the NCAA Committee on Infractions places your team on 4 years of probation, bans your team from the upcoming postseason as a result of a violation involving impermissible benefits. So now Georgia Tech in the process of appealing those as the season begins. And the good news for Yellow Jackets fans, until the appeals panel reaches a decision, all punishments won't go into effect, but an added stress on Josh Pastner and this Georgia Tech program.
It is, yeah. I mean, you feel bad for the players. You know, they felt optimistic about their year to be able to compete in postseason play. But that's where we are now. I mean, NC State going through their own NCAA stuff. So, I mean, we have seen a lot of this uncovered, and we got two programs here tonight who were hit by it.
Battle for the ball at the top of the court. Yeah, you mentioned it, Chris. It's been really all across the country, not just the two teams at the gym tonight. Everybody, every conference seems to be dealing with this problem. You mentioned NC State Wolfpack charged with multiple violations, including two level one most severe penalties. But I think the main thing to point out is those violations came under a former head coach in Mark Gottfried and centered around Dennis Smith, a player long gone from this program.
And a former athletic director. So they have two. They have a new AD, Drew Corrigan, and a new head coach since that stuff has come down.
Devin Daniels knocks down the three. So really nobody involved currently with the program is associated with those penalties, but it is something that these two teams, as well as teams across the country, continue to deal with.
And there's Jose Alvarado on attack. And he's come in on a mission. Not happy with how he played last year. Certainly not happy with how his team played. He is on a mission. The New York guard.
NC State, they can't miss. C.J. Bryce connects again. And it's everybody on the Wolfpack, not just one or two guys, pouring it on at his first half. Right quickly to the other end. Scoop to the hoop for Khalid Moore. This is a tempo that this game has not been played under typically between Josh Pastner and Kevin Keats. And years past, the Yellow Jackets have dictated the tempo. Now it's NC State with a faster pace. That rims out for Beverly. Moore trying to run again, dunks inside.
Nice pass.
Can't finish the three though. And a foul called on the rebound against James Banks.
Well, that's a big foul. I mean, that's his second, and he's been active. Leading shot blocker in the ACC last year was James Banks. Really alters a lot of stuff at their basket.
Did NC State already into the bonus, so we get foul shots with a little less than 6 minutes to play. Danny Dixon at the line. Misses the front end of that 1-1. Oh. the fingertips of Evan Cole. Another turnover. That's six against the Yellow Jackets in his first half.
And that's where Georgia Tech has run a little bit more than they typically do, and I think in part because they want to beat that half-court defense down. NC State has been so good. We haven't seen the press have a whole lot of an effect in terms of turning Georgia Tech over there, but in the half court, man, they have really gotten after Georgia Tech.
Well, you said coming into the game, contrasting styles between these two teams, and it's been all Wolfpack in that department. Stolen away here by Georgia Tech, though. Alvarado pulls the trigger. No good. NC State off and running again. Daniels straight to the rim. Off the window for two. Foul called against NC State. Evan Cole shoved off the ball. Hellum second foul.
You know, it's worth mentioning too with how well NC State shot it from three tonight in this half, that the three-point line moved back about 2 feet to that international line. It's about 22 feet at the top of the key. It's a little bit shorter, the corner shots, but it'll be interesting to see. I don't think it'll affect attempts. I think teams are going to shoot it at the same rate, but it'll be interesting to see if percentages dip a little bit, at least in the early going.
Yeah, both of these teams have played with that international line, though. Georgia Tech did it in Spain, and NC State was part of the experimental in the NIT. Shot clock violation. Great defense from the Wolfpack.
That half-court defense has been so active. And they're playing with two new guys in that starting lineup, in Bates and Andre. They're playing without Markel Johnson, who's so good at getting after the ball, and yet that half-court defense has been locked in this first half for NC State.
Alvarado almost got it away from Daniels. Braxton Beverly, pop off the drive, nothing but air, but kept alive on the line. It'll stay with the Wolfpack, eight to shoot. C.J. Bryce muscling his way in, throws it up. C.J. Bryce, everything he has put up in the air has found its way to the bottom of the cup. Fouled on his way to the hoop. James Banks at the foul line. When we come back, C.J. Bryce started his career at Tola. Jay Alter with you, Chris. It's a simple game. You turn the ball over, your opponent makes threes, you're going to be losing.
But what's amazing is Georgia Tech was a top 50 defensive team last year. In this first half, NC State is shooting 51% from the field, 62% from three. I mean, it's been their offense. Now, their defense has been locked in, and we've talked about the turnovers, but there's been zero resistance from Georgia Tech on the defensive end. And I think Josh Pastner's tried to figure out the zone really hasn't provided the resistance. They've gone to more man-to-man in this half than they typically play. But NC State is firing on all cylinders and from a lot of different guys.
And this is a Wolfpack team missing their star guard, Markel Johnson, out with an ankle injury. And big man DJ Funderburk, who's indefinitely suspended. So you take out arguably the two best players on this team. Other guys step up, and they have looked really good to start this season. Daniel somehow keeps his dribble alive, denied at the rim, all the way up to Michael DeVoe. Great outlet pass, and he's fouled hard on his way to the rim.
And a hard play there by Braxton Beverly, you know, not giving up a layup. You love the toughness from him. And this has been the one area where Georgia Tech's had a little bit of success offensively, is getting out. And so
Certainly looked like he hit his head there at the end of it, but a good play by Beverly to force the foul shots. Well, that's where DeVoe just kind of leaked out and caught the outlet pass and had the one-on-one down back. That's a really solid beard that Braxton Beverly is sporting. I mean, that's like a six-month growth of thickage right there. I really love that.
That is not November beard. That is more than 5 days old.
That's a commitment right there.
Would you ever consider growing yours out to that length?
I have, Jay Alter. I have considered that.
I don't know your grooming patterns. Forgive me. Maddie Bates lost it underneath. The Georgia Tech's found success in transition. Go right back to it. Blocking foul called on Braxton Beverly. That's his third. He picked up two in less than a minute.
But I don't like him trying this with the two fouls. I don't mind the last one because you only got the one. And I don't like that call. I think that's a charge. I think that's a charge.
So even though it's a charge, do you still not like him trying?
I don't like my point guard making that play.
Right. Especially with Markel Johnson out of the game.
There's no doubt about it. Because now that's his third foul. He's going to have to sit the rest of the half, and it makes him a different player. At least early in the second half. But what a play it was. And I don't want to take away from the defensive play. It's the first game for these officials as well.
So C.J. Bryce, who at times will play the four for the Wolfpack, taking the ball up with both Beverly out of the game and Johnson out injured. A.J. Taylor, his first touch of the season, and it's a turnover. Up ahead, risky pass somehow pays off. Banks flies in for the finish. James Banks rocks the rim.
We've seen two monster dunks in his first half. The alley-oop for Manny Bates early in this first half, and then that one right there. Making like Inspector Gadget. Go-Go Gadget arms. Look at the delivery here, running the lane, and right up over the top for James Banks.
Big time finish for the senior.
And that got deflected a little bit. Manny Bates got a piece of that. And Banks still finishing through traffic. What a play.
You're physically imposing on the court, both offensively and defensively. Coming into his senior season, Banks an opportunity to really establish himself as one of the best big men in this conference.
Right. Well, he was last year. Again, he led the league in shot blocking. He's developed an offensive game. He's been very active in this first half. Speaking of style choices, have you noticed the new officiating shirts they're sporting this year? I'm told it's a Raglan style shoulder. They're trying to modernize the look of the officials this year. I respect the hustle.
I did not notice until you pointed it out, but I do like the style change. Banks, big finish again.
Did you know that it was a Raglan style?
No, Raglan. It's
a Raglan style shoulder.
No, I have not read up on that. I've read up on the rules changes, but not the officiating wardrobe changes.
Yes, along with the rules changes, we're trying to modernize the officials. I don't know how Jamie Lucky's taking to that. He's been around a long time, but he looks good in the new Raglan style shoulder.
I think that's more important than the three-point line moving out. Now James Banks has had two back-to-back rim rockers. Let's see if they go back to number one in gold. Can't get it to him. 10 to shoot. Price triggers a three. Too much on it. Final 90 seconds of this first half. NC State looking to add to the 9-point lead. Long rebound. Georgia Tech runs with it. DeVoe weaving his way to the rim and is fouled.
Transition's been good for Georgia Tech. It's really the only way they've been able to get some consistent offense in this first half. You know, Josh Pastner telling us earlier today, there were about 9 games last year that if Georgia Tech could have mustered about 6 or 7 percentage points better at the three-point line, they would have won those games. I mean, they're just so bad as a team shooting from three last year. And that's what that Princeton offense gets you. The Princeton offense is about getting open jump shots. That's why Pete Carril had an undersized team, a slower team, a team that was good passing, good IQ. And that's what it's designed for.
In today's modern game, though, you don't see a lot of it, especially in the ACC.
You see derivations, you know, like the John Beilein system that has permeated through a lot of programs is a derivation. It's not, and that's what Pastor's running. It's a derivation of it, but still a lot of the same principles and a lot of open jump shots.
Georgia Tech having success in transition. Not exactly their game, but they've crawled their way back into this game. Only a 7-point deficit of 2 foul shots upcoming. They've kind of quietly crept back into a first half that the Wolfpack have dominated from the start.
And they've gotten to the foul line. You know, NC State, in part because of their style, sent teams to the foul line at the highest rate in the league last year.
And NC State offensively has gone cold. Their last made basket came at the 4-minute mark, so 3 minutes without watching that ball go to the bottom of the net. And no doubt about it, Braxton Beverly coming out of the game with his 3rd foul has definitely delivered a blow to the rhythm of this Wolfpack offense.
Well, and Pat Andre not making threes. You know, I think Georgia Tech has locked in even tighter on him, perhaps fatigue setting in. And there's Braxton Beverly, who's got the 3 fouls.
It's a 7-0 Georgia Tech run, trying to close out this first half strongly. The rebound. Both teams in the bonus. AJ Taylor at the line with 40 seconds remaining in this first half.
It's amazing how coaches are putting rosters together these days. You know, NC State's got 2 grad transfers, AJ Taylor, a junior college player. Just kind of manufacturing players from different angles. And it's for, in a lot of cases, freshmen are not necessarily the primary target. Or incoming freshmen, I should say.
A lot of ways you can build a team, not just adding, you know, seniors in high school. Timeout taken by Georgia Tech. 9 seconds separating the shot clock and the game clock. We'll step aside. Wolfpack up by 7 right before halftime. Points for Georgia Tech has clawed their way back into it. Less than 30 seconds until halftime. He's pushed the draw on Jay Alter. You can't point to anything offensively. The Yellow Jackets aren't really shooting the ball much better, but somehow, some way, they're back in this game and looking for more.
Well, they've been better at taking care of the ball over the last 5 minutes of this half, and their defense has locked in.
Braxton Beverly on the bench for NC State has held the Wolfpack on a drought, trying to get back into it with some defense. A.J. Taylor on the rejection. Shot clock is off. Andre a 3. No good. Follow finish not there. And that does it for the opening half on opening night between Georgia Tech and NC State. Coming up after the break. Sounds like you would stay in it.
I would, absolutely. And what it does is you can identify shooters. You know, again, when a team comes out and hits 4 quick threes and you're playing a zone, the only way to take them off that line is to match up.
Braxton Beverly back on the court after 3 fouls in that first half. sat the last 4 minutes, so that's really what got Georgia Tech back into this game. Wolfpack led by as much as 16. That lead is down to 7 to start this second half. Deep inside. Can't get the finish. Kick out to Vaux. Alvarado, patient approach from Georgia Tech on their possession, and the extra pass pays off.
And he had a sixth sense. He knew where Banks was and had to spin himself around in the lane in order to find them. But what a drop-off that was by Jose Alvarado.
Alvarado also playing with 3 fouls, so the 2-point guards have to be careful in the second half. Daniels, a hesitation and a nice kiss off the glass.
What a finish that was by Daniels. Really inconsistent last year, up and down all year for Devin Daniels. Hoping he can give them a little bit more offense this year.
Great pass from James Banks, but off the fingertips of Khalid Moore. That's the first turnover of more than 10 minutes for Georgia Tech. Especially with Markel Johnson out of this game, you cannot undersell enough Braxton Beverley's presence on the court. When he is on it, this offense has been humming. Pull-up jumper. Gets his own rebound, keeps the play alive. The floater does not fall. Great hustle. Wide open, DeVoe cut away. It's as easy a bucket as you'll see all season. Just like that, Yellow Jackets have crept within 5 points. Bryce pull up pop. It's good. C.J. Bryce.
You know, one thing with no Markel Johnson and Georgia Tech playing a man-to-man, they're not really as effective in their ball screen stuff. Nice finish there.
Georgia Tech has found something in transition. The offense really starting to get going.
And another great pass by Jose Alvarado to Khalid Moore, and what a finish through the contact. Jose Alvarado, Khalid Moore were AAU teammates. Moore actually, both guys from New York. Khalid Moore played at Molloy High School in the city, was teammates with Cole Anthony and Moses Brown. Cole Anthony now at North Carolina, Moses Brown now with the Portland Trail Blazers. Played for an AAU team in New York, the Wrens, coached by a guy named Andy Borman.
Foul called on Moses Wright. Reached in on Manny Bates. His second.
That AAU team, when Alvarado was on a team with Jordan Wara, who's at Louisville, Hamidou Diallo, who's in the NBA, and Jordan Tucker, who signed with Duke and then transferred to Butler. Just a really good AAU program. Of course, Alvarado from Christ the King High School, famed New York City High School.
Bryce, that one rattles in and out. With Alvarado, too, that was definitely the number one guy that Josh Pastner wanted, like the toughness, like the experience that he could bring immediately into ACC play. And he has got his offense rolling. Now Georgia Tech within 3. This is the closest this game has been since it was 4-0 at the beginning of it. That's the 4th foul called against Jose Alvarado.
And just caught in a mismatch here. C.J. Bryce just too small against Moses Wright. And you love the patience from Moses.
That's a big foul call. As Alvarado forced out of this game with his 4th foul. A lot of game left. So Georgia Tech without their floor general for the foreseeable future. Daniels trying to take advantage of it, and he does. Download to James Banks. Denied again. Manny Bates has been terrific defensively in the post. Swatted away underneath by Moses Wright.
A big time block. The length of Moses Wright and then here James Banks has been a game changer in this defense. I mean, what a block that was to not commit a foul. He goes straight up, the verticality there. The ACC's leading shot blocker last season, James Banks.
Showing why in the season opener on the road. Charges the call. Jericho Helms getting himself in position. NC State leading by five. Georgia Tech's junior point guard Jose Alvarado out of the game right now with four fouls. Very rare you would see Alvarado out of the game at all in his first 2 years of the Yellow Jackets. 13 games where he played the entire 40 minutes. So this team not used to playing without their floor general. 7 points. But he does a lot more that doesn't even show up in the box score. When would you put him back into this game?
Yeah, he's got his warm-up on. Like, he's going to sit there for a little bit. You may be able to go some offense, defense with him, but to put him back in full-hearted, I don't think you do that until about 7 minutes. He's too important. Because if you're NC State, you're just going to drive him. Whoever he's matched up with, you're going to drive him and force him to play defense.
Banks getting the better of Bates on that matchup down low. He's Chris Padola, I'm Jay Aldridge. I agree. I just want to watch the score. He came out of that game when it was a three-point game, 46-43. You just don't want to let NC State separate themselves and take advantage of Alvarado on the bench too long. Here's Moses Wright working on Pat Andre. Takes him into the post. Contact and a charge is the call.
It's good position defense here. And you know, Andre, he's got both a tough angle there to see exactly how much contact. But, I mean, he's certainly backing him in. He's got 2 feet on that floor in legal guarding position.
The question coming into the season was not, can Pat Andre shoot? We know he can, shooting better than 40% in his career. It's, can he defend at an ACC level? So far tonight, how do you think he's done?
I think he's been fine. He certainly hasn't been exposed. I mean, you know, his offense, he's got to be able to do something else besides shoot the basketball, especially at that position. But the one thing he does give them is he does stretch the floor. I mean, you have to identify him. And that's the spacing that Kevin Keats has talked about that Pat Andre gives them because of his threat to shoot it.
Timeout, Georgia Tech. Wolfpack leading by 5, 15 left to the second half. We've got a good one. NC State thought they got a win. Torin Doran, a three. Only 6 seconds left, but that's plenty of time for Georgia Tech. Alvarado the drive, James Banks finish, plus the foul. Georgia Tech wins that game 63-61. Alongside Chris Petola, I'm Jay Alter. Yellow Jackets trailed as much as 16, but they're back within 5, setting up for what could be a finish very similar to a year ago. One big difference in that game was played March 6th, as DeVoe drills a three, and you don't have to wait till March. You get it opening night as these two go punch for punch. 2-point game here in Raleigh.
What execution out of the timeout by Georgia Tech. A screen to screener. DeVoe wide open at the top of the key.
Here's C.J. Bryce. Another great block by the ACC leader, but Georgia Tech gives it away after the Banks rejection. Daniels on the drive. Banks almost got there again.
They are so long at the rim.
Does not go. Inside to Andre. Nothing going down for the Wolfpack right now. Up to Banks. Ooh! A flush that ties this game at 48.
How the run from James Banks. And he ran with his hand up. What a find. This dude is playing his rear end off. Look at the communication, the nonverbal, got the hand up, and he just runs the middle of the floor, rim to rim. What a game James Banks is having.
Tied at 48 for the first time since it was 0-0. Georgia Tech has not led it this game, trailed by as much as 16. Right back in it with 13:35 to play.
Braxton Beverly back in this game with the three fouls.
Much needed. Jericho Helms drills a three. Can't do it. Offensive rebound, taking it into a double team, but Banks everything but the finish. Banks with 12 points, 10 rebounds, so a double-double, and he's got four blocks as well. Moses Wright getting in on the block game. You said it, Chris. They are long at the rim, and they have been everywhere in the second half.
It didn't look like it from where we're sitting, but they, you know, and they're not just long, they're reactive, they're aware, and as you know, they react to the position of the basketball.
Great positioning, and Moses Wright cashes in. Time driving in, dish to Danny Dixon, nothing going. Bryce ends up with it, and Georgia Tech a monster underneath now. They have taken NC State completely out of their rhythm. That one almost rolled in, instead bounced out.
I mean, this is not just being physically capable, this is about good timing, about effort, about being aware. Those two guys have erased a lot of stuff at their basket. And this is where, if you're NC State, you miss Markel Johnson. Because, again, they run a lot of ball screen stuff, and it's all predicated on Johnson and his ability to be creative, to get into the paint, to settle the team down.
Cross-court pass by C.J. Bryce, pulls the trigger, hits it. When NC State has needed a bucket, they've turned to Bryce, and he's delivered. A two-point lead as we step aside. This one's going to be a fun finish in Raleigh.
Wingspan, but he's played hard. He's been active. He's been alert. He's been physical. He has been all over the place. And it's not just the eight blocks. He's got another eight that he has altered. He and Moses Wright at that basket have changed this game in the second half. Big reason it's a two-point game.
And along with the blocks, 14 points, 10 rebounds for the senior. He has really grown into this game. And NC State. They started 14 of 27 from the floor. Since then, 5 of 24. Georgia Tech looking for their first lead of the game. Would have gone if that three fell. It did not. Here's Braxton Beverly. Takes it himself. Blocked. But that one, definite goaltend.
There's no question about that, but I'll tell you what, if you're Braxton Beverly, you'll think twice on that next one in lane. I mean, it's a good drive, and that's basically volleyball off the backboard.
Well, we just showed you all the blocks of Georgia Tech, giving no signs that that'll end in the final 11 minutes. Everything that goes up on the inside is being contested. Give and go. And a foul is the call as Moore was getting his footing.
It's important to note Jose Alvarado back in the game with the four fouls.
They go inside and Moses Wright delivers.
And I think part of the reason you feel comfortable bringing him back is how well the team played without him.
Andre tries a three off the mark. He started 3 for 3 from beyond the arc. He's really cooled down. That's a foul against Moses Wright. And that's the fourth against Moses Wright. So both Jose Alvarado and Moses Wright on the court with four fouls right now. We still got more than 10 minutes left in this game. Devin Daniels driving on Wright. Wright stayed aggressive with four fouls. It pays off, but very risky.
And that could have been called.
On the other end, Moses Wright ties the game. Back-to-back buckets for the Raleigh Natives.
I'm surprised Josh Pasker let Moses Wright in. I mean, that could have been five right there on the other play, but he's riding with him, and he gives him offense on the other end.
Working on Alvarado, who also reaches in. I'll tell you what, Georgia Tech staying very aggressive, and that one's going to cost him. Moses Wright, with his fifth foul, will foul out of this game. Josh Pasker is livid. Final 10 minutes of this game will be spent without the junior, Moses Wright.
Here's the thing, okay? You're a lot more comfortable with a guard who has four fouls playing him with 10 minutes left in this game than a big guy. Especially one like Moses Wright who only knows one speed. That's a foul. There's no question about that. That is a foul.
And we spoke to Wright yesterday, and he said he grew up 6 miles away from campus. He plays with more passion in this game because NC State did not recruit him, and he was in their backyard.
That's great, Jay, but passion is one thing. When you got four fouls in a game like this,
oh, I totally agree with you.
And, you know, you just can't. You got to take that guy out of the game, and then if not, Moses Wright's got to be smarter than that.
So both on the player, obviously, because he did continue to play aggressive. There were two or three non-calls that could have been, but Josh Pasker has to recognize that and take him out of the game. Here's James Banks, and that's an offensive foul. That's Banks' third. Foul called.
Khalid Moore has shown some flashes here tonight. You know, I think he's probably more comfortable playing at the four. He's kind of a tweener. But with Moses Wright and James Banks, they've got Moore at the three. Not really a shooter, but he shows you there what he does. He's so athletic. He's got good size, about 6'7".
And we are back tied at 57. Four fouls now. He stays in the game as the fouls continue to stockpile. And that's number four against James Banks. So that's quickly becoming the story.
And you got to take him out. I mean, you have to take him out of the game. And it looks like Josh Pastner is going to do that.
Evan Cole comes in for Banks.
Backdoor cut and a good finish by Cole.
Cole was originally committed to play for Coach Kevin Keats at UNC Wilmington. He takes the NC State job and Georgia Tech scooped him up. How about Jericho Helen drilling a three in the answer? It's a turnover.
Helms not known as a three-point shooter, but on the penetration that sucks the entire defense into the lane, Helms wide open, a great find, and he steps in and nails it.
The sophomore has 13 points as a foul. He's called that one on Michael DeVoe, his second. Helms has been great, 13 points, two threes. A sophomore that Coach Keats said could make a big step up from his freshman year. And remember, every foul now will send NC State to the foul line. And so it looked like Josh Pastner originally told James Banks to sub back into the game, only to tell him to sit back down on the bench. Remember, Georgia Tech already without Moses Wright, another big man for the remainder of the night as he's fouled out.
And free throw shooting going to be a big part of how this game is decided. Georgia Tech in the double bonus, NC State in the 1-1.
Alvarado lost the handle, somehow got it back. Khalid Moore. And the turnovers continue to pile up. That's number 14 against Georgia Tech.
And there's a switch on the ball screen.
A mismatch here. Beverly trying to take advantage. The follow in perfect position. C.J. Bryce. Tech moving quickly and a foul call.
You know, to the point where NC State can be deliberate, you got to go right at Banks. I mean, you got to force him to play defense, see if you can draw that fifth.
And James Banks has subbed into the game, so the senior playing with four fouls. And after both foul shots, we've got a four-point game. Jose Alvarado also in the game for Georgia Tech, as the Yellow Jackets, who traditionally are in a 2-3 zone, have gone man the entire second half. Bryce, spin move, can't get it to drop. Risky pass. Somehow kept alive by Georgia Tech. Alvarado somehow gets on the other end of it. 10 seconds to shoot. They go to the junior point guard. Jose Alvarado. Into traffic, goes up with it, does not go down.
That was a good look. That was well defended by Jericho Helms. Stayed back, stayed big, and didn't foul.
Straight to the cup, everything but the finish for Devin Daniels. And Josh Pastner takes a timeout. Both teams lacking some offensive rhythm in the second half. It's remarkable that Georgia Tech is even in the game with how good the Wolfpack looked out of the gate. Built a lead of 15 in that first half. But it is a brand new ballgame.
Well, and part of it is this game has slowed to the pace that Georgia Tech wants. And I think that's, you know, it has forced, and NC State has adjusted to their credit. It has forced NC State to execute in the half court. It'll be interesting to see how the foul trouble for Banks affects their defense, because a big part of their defense tonight in that man-to-man has been the rim protection for number one.
Into it and hits.
What a shot fake. You gotta love it. Shot fake into the shot. Nicely done by DeVoe.
CJ Bryce has been the go-to guy in clutch spots tonight. Up and under. And gets that to fall.
He has been big, and it's that mid-range. He's just been a mid-range savant throughout this game. He gets to his spot in that mid-range, the athlete to pull up.
Alvarado looking for the answer. He's got it! Jose Alvarado, a huge three.
That's their fourth three on the night. They're 4 of 13. Have not shot it well, but a big one there from Alvarado.
Owing within one with a little more than 5 minutes to play. Daniels rims out, and Alvarado chases down the board.
Three on the other end by Jose Alvarado, and if you're Beverly, you can't be that far off. I know you want to shrink the floor and protect on a drive there, but you've got to stay home, because that's what Alvarado is going to do. Did not shoot it well last year, but as a freshman, 37%, certainly capable.
15 turnovers, costly for Georgia Tech, and yet the Yellow Jackets only down by one. CJ Bryce, pull up, pop, connects again.
That that's been his shot, right in that mid-range.
He leads the Wolfpack with 18. Here's James Banks into the post, playing with four fouls. Great move and finish.
That is advanced post play right there by James Banks. Got to go back to Bryce.
Leading scorer. Step back. It goes again. C.J. Bryce. Unstoppable. He's got 20. Alvarado a three. Off the mark. Bates couldn't secure the board, but got back to play some great defense. Jump ball forced by the redshirt freshman.
CJ Bryce making like MJ in this mid-range.
Presented by Geico. 15 minutes could save you 15% or more on car insurance. As we welcome you back to ACC Network Basketball, presented by Geico, alongside Chris Petrola, I am Jay Alder. The history between these two teams, the last 3 years, all decided by 3 points or less, and we are getting more of the same tonight. The bonus for the fans at home, usually you have to wait until after the new year for ACC basketball. You get it on opening night. The season starts, and in the ACC, the best basketball conference of the country. No surprise it's going down to the wire. Jose Alvarado defending Braxton Beverly with four fouls. He's played with four fouls for most of this second half. CJ Bryce, he's been the go-to guy. Leads the team with 20 points. Lost the handle, though. Great defense by Khalid Moore. And they say it was a shove on CJ Bryce. Foul against the redshirt senior will be Georgia Tech ball.
What a defensive possession by Khalid Moore. Didn't back down, stayed in front, little poke away there, and then he gets after the loose ball. And it's a 50-50 ball, and look, when guys go down like that, I mean, there's no problem with that call. But what a defensive play by Khalid Moore there. Stood his ground and induced the turnover.
A 1-1 coming for the sophomore. Makes the front end.
Kid's got a bright future, man. He's played well tonight. 6'7", a little over 200 pounds, only a sophomore.
11 points on the night, and we've got a one-point game with 3 minutes to play in Raleigh. Georgia Tech has never led in this game. NC State led by as much as 15. Right back to Bryce, attacks, and it rolls in.
It was good defense and better offense. CJ Bryce getting himself in the lane again. What a shot and finish.
Leads the Wolfpack with 22. Alvarado, too much pace on that ball. DeVoe tracked it down though. Hits the three. Michael DeVoe ties this game at 73. Timeout, NC State.
We are seeing some shot making down the stretch in this game. Look at that one right there. I mean, well defended. And CJ Bryce with the touch in the lane, and then just too much space. Hand down, man down, and Michael DeVoe. Pulling up the lefty right in the face of the defender. What a big shot that was to answer.
It was impressive. He even got the ball back, kept the possession alive, but then would step into that three and drill it to tie this game at 73. Something else for the sophomore.
You imagine out of this timeout, they're going back to Bryce.
on the ice. Started his career with Kevin Keats at UNCW. After his sophomore year, where he was a first-teamer of the Colonial, he sat out to continue to play for Keats at NC State. Now in his fifth and final year, and the lights are on for C.J. Bryce in the opener. Final 2 minutes, and we're tied at 73. Helms into the paint, fading away, and a foul is called. Helms will head to the line.
It's a silly foul by the freshman. It's just a silly foul. Make him make that shot. Fading away, under 2 minutes in a tie ball game. Make Jericho Helms make that shot. Instead, you foul a guy who's fading away from the basket, and you give him two free throws.
Rattles the first one home to put the Wolf back up. Face kicked to Helms, can't bury it. Kept alive by Bates. It's a loose ball. Georgia Tech has it. And a timeout taken by Jose Alvarado. Tied at 75 with a minute and 6 seconds. It's Georgia Tech basketball.
And that's their last timeout, but what a heads-up play by Alvarado. And how about this heads-up play? He's had about four passes tonight where there's no way he could see his teammate. He just sensed where he was. What a dime that was. And how about Banks filling that spot for the finish? Jose Alvarado with a dime.
That play was eerily similar from a year ago in this building. Georgia Tech with Jose Alvarado goes the length of the court and dishes to Banks for almost identical dunk. This is after NC State thought they won the game on that three. This is identical. Great feed.
Well, he's just so good at reacting to the defense. I mean, there on that play, the defense helps up. And he drops it off, and then on the last one again, the defense collapses to help. Banks fills the lane nicely, and just a nice wraparound play.
So Georgia Tech out of timeouts for the final minute and 6 seconds of this game. They do have the basketball. Yellow Jackets have not led for a single second of this game.
And it's worth mentioning, that guy there is playing with four fouls, and Alvarado's played the last 10 minutes of this half with four fouls.
And Josh Pastor, he's come all the way out to midcourt screaming at his team, "We are out of timeouts. We are out of timeouts."
Come on, Wolfpack Nation, let's go. Get out. We need you.
NC State will come with full court pressure. Final minute, opening night of college basketball, and we've got a great one in the ACC. 10 seconds to shoot. Alvarado on the move. DeVoe, 5 seconds to put it up. Kick to the corner. No good from Khalid Moore. And now 8 seconds separates the shot clock to the game clock for NC State. And Kevin Keats uses his final timeout.
This ball, I don't care how you get it to him. with the last 10 minutes that he has had, this ball's got to go to CJ Bryce.
Wolfpack playing without their star senior Markel Johnson. In the first half, you wouldn't have noticed it. But in a play like this, a sequence like this against an ACC opponent, first game of the season, you would look to your senior point guard to make a play.
You would, and he's not here. And that guy has been no punk tonight. I mean, he's a redshirt senior, grizzled veteran, former CAA Player of the Year. I think he has now adjusted to ACC life. I think he's poised for a monster season. This night, I think foreshadowing that, the ball's got to go to him. And he's done a nice job with that matchup. And you assume Khalid Moore will be the guy on him with his length. Khalid Moore about 2 inches taller.
Right now,
there's 8.7 seconds that separates the game clock from the shot clock.
What a game this has been, Parker.
Boy, are we happy college basketball is back. And to bring it in on the ACC Network,
we need you right now,
ACC school going punch for punch in the second half. Playing with four fouls. NC State cannot hold for the last shot. 10 seconds on the shot clock. Beverly on the drive. The dish. Helms. No good. Bouncing around. 7 seconds left in this game. NC State has the rebound and a jump ball. And Georgia Tech has the arrow. Neither team had a timeout. It was Pat Andre who originally had possession, but without a timeout to call, Georgia Tech got in there, got tough. And it'll be Yellow Jackets basketball with 5.5 seconds remaining in regulation. Who do you draw it up for?
Well, you get Alvarado's going to get the ball, much like last year, and just drive the lane and find the open player. Here he goes.
3 seconds. Alvarado for the win. And we are headed to overtime in the ACC on opening night. Conference play on opening night. It is delivered to the ACC. 5 more minutes on the clock. Overtime. 7 ties. But no lead. And it's James Banks, the senior, who has been a monster on defense and offense. 5 blocks and a double-double to go with it. Who wins the tip for Georgia Tech to get us started in overtime. Freshman trying a three and drills it. Asante Price starts overtime. It gives Georgia Tech their first lead of the night.
NC State is switching 1 through 4. But when they get that 1-5 pick and roll, it's sucking in the defense on the backside. And that's how that shooter gets wide open.
Beverly off the mark trying to answer. And it's Georgia Tech basketball.
When Georgia Tech's finally able to get that switch. This is a different possession. That's that last shot there.
Well, it took 40 minutes and 30 seconds, but Georgia Tech with a lead in this game for the first time tonight. going inside. Here's Banks working on the redshirt freshman Bates. Ooh. No good. The follow blows but does not fall. Ball on the ground after Moore poked it free. Alvarado emerges with it up to Defoe. Plenty of contact. Nothing called.
That was a good no call. I thought Braxton Beverly played that well, and that's not an easy play to make without fouling.
And that time a foul is called on the aggressive Khalid Moore. His third foul. Both teams will be shooting foul shots on every foul the rest of the way. Moses Wright fouled out of this game with 10 minutes to go in the second half. They've been without the junior for a long time. Alvarado and Banks off on the court with four fouls as well.
Now, give Braxton Beverly a lot of credit. Without Markel Johnson, he's run the point tonight. He's been in foul trouble, but he's done a nice job. Leading his team, being that floor general they've needed.
What is going to separate these two teams in the final 3 minutes of overtime?
That's a heck of a question. Not much has separated them all night.
Inside, here's the senior Banks. Dish off underneath. More points from behind by Manny Bates.
We have seen three of the best shot blockers in this conference in this game. Two of them from Georgia Tech. The other one, Manny Bates, only a redshirt freshman, but what a job he's done. Five blocks on the night for Bates.
Banks goes right back to him. Didn't realize that the shot clock was expiring, and that's a crucial mistake by Georgia Tech giving NC State the ball back.
That's two possessions where NC State's half-court man-to-man defense has stepped up. Two big stops by the Wolfpack D.
Beverly right back to work. Seconds to shoot. Junior pull up jumper, no good. Unfriendly roll. Ball is loose and a jump ball is the call. Stays with NC State. Each team did get a timeout for overtime, but they ran out of timeouts in regulation. The shot clock. Beverly spins into a corner, and somehow it goes down to put the Wolfpack back in front. DeVoe, it rings in the answer from the sophomore, Michael DeVoe. Two teams just go back and forth. Beverly, too much on it. Alvarado trying to pick a pass, risky, and it's intercepted by C.J. Bryce.
Cool. It looks like Alvarado cramped up after making that play. And NC State had an advantage. 5-on-4, and a nice job by Alvarado just to read that pass by Beverly.
Hey, Jay Bryce, leading scorer who's been quiet so far in overtime. And it's a travel, went into the double team and could not handle it.
And a nice defensive play, just kind of pulling the chair out on him as he goes into that spin.
Timeout, Georgia Tech. Josh Pastor wants to talk things over with a minute and 12 seconds left in overtime and a one-point lead.
Remember, I was taking risks, living life right, go hard and I'm quick, go hard, just flash like that ice on the wrist.
When you look at the history between these two teams the last 3 years, all three games decided by 3 points or less. But to get this on the opening night of college basketball in the ACC on a brand new network, it's something special.
Yeah.
That's how tight it's been. In the game last year, as we pointed out, came down to a dunk at the buzzer. And I think both, look, it's game one of a long season. This is a marathon, it's not a sprint. I thought both teams settled into this game. You know, NC State came out and made those threes early. I think it was intoxicating. I think it got them off to a hot start. It's not necessarily who they are. And I think both teams settled in. I think Georgia Tech's defense settled in. And now, I mean, they've really, in this overtime, gone shot for shot. This is one of those plays where, again, I think Alvarado's going to have it. They're going to try to get in their ball screen stuff the matchup that they want. And they're going to go to work. And it's been Alvarado and DuVoe over the last several minutes for Georgia Tech who have made big-time offensive plays.
Georgia Tech took its first lead of the night in overtime, now trying to protect a one-point advantage in the final 1 minute and 12 seconds. They have the basketball. It's funny, Kevin Keats, 45 wins in his first two seasons. He's beaten every ACC team except for three. Virginia, well, they've been so dominant. A few teams have. Virginia Tech and Georgia Tech. They've been a thorn in this NC State side for the last two seasons and trying to open the season with a road win here in Raleigh.
Georgia Tech has been the one team that has not succumbed to the tempo that NC State wants to play. NC State presses you, they want to run, they play at the fastest tempo in the league. Georgia Tech, they play a 2-3 zone, and they run that Princeton offense. They are very deliberate, and they have never succumbed to that NC State tempo.
Both teams in the bonus. Georgia Tech now without a timeout. NC State still has theirs. Jose Alvarado played the final 10 minutes of that second half with four fouls, stayed in this game. He has been the go-to guy for the Yellow Jackets tonight. Reliable with the ball in his hands. Goes to work off the bank screen. DuVoe, a three. No good. And Manny Bates grabs it.
It's a good look. It's a play they've run a lot in this overtime. A good look.
And a foul called. And that'll send C.J. Bryce to the line to try and take the lead from the free throw line.
C.J. Bryce last year, 75% from the foul line, a good free throw shooter. Game one of the season. This is a big spot right here.
And Bryce has not attempted a foul shot so far tonight. He does lead the Wolfpack with 22 points. NC State very good from the foul line tonight. 19 of 22. And Bryce gives the Wolfpack the lead. Georgia timeout. 4 seconds separating the shot clock and the game clock. Alvarado looking for Banks. Ripped away by Devin Daniels. Manny Banks lost the ball. It's loose. Georgia Tech somehow has it. 10 seconds for the Yellow Jackets. Up to Alvarado. Pull up three. No good. Yellow Jackets still have it. Banks. And a foul is called with 2.1 seconds left.
Devin Daniels, where are you going? You're up a point. They're going to have to foul you, and you're trying to throw it to Manny Bates, your big guy, running the middle of the floor. And Georgia Tech recovers, and what a frenetic possession on the other end.
A chaotic sequence ends with James Banks, the senior big man for Georgia Tech, at the line with an opportunity to tie or put them in front with 2.1 seconds remaining. Kevin Keats urging his crowd into a full voice. And we're tied at 81.
That was pure.
And a timeout taken, the final one for Kevin Keats. With one more foul shot still to come from James Banks, an opportunity to give Georgia Tech the lead.
I don't know if the ice is something that works. It never worked on me. But you got to try whatever you can with 2 seconds left in this game. James Banks, 68% from the foul line last year. That first shot he just took was pure.
Take another look.
A great defensive play by Devin Daniels. Where are you going, though? They got a foul, and you're trying to hit your big guy right in the middle of the floor. Just not a smart play. And then Georgia Tech recovers, goes the other direction. And just a crazy possession here. Presence of mind to Khalid Moore to find Banks, and then Banks draws the foul.
Banks 2 for 2 from the foul line tonight. The game is on his shoulders. And he hits it. NC State without a timeout. 2 seconds to try and steal this game from Georgia Tech. Into Beverly. Has to let it fly and does. No good! Georgia Tech hangs on. A statement road win to start this season.
What a game. What a game and what a win for Georgia Tech.
The Yellow Jackets did not lead for a single second in regulation, but they will leave Raleigh with an overtime victory.
They earned this one. Got down big early and then just chipped away. Closed it at the end of the first half. And as you said, did not take the lead until overtime. And my goodness, what a job by James Banks, Jose Alvarado, Michael DeVoe. Played without Moses Wright for the last 10 minutes of this game. What a job by Georgia Tech.
A year ago, James Banks won this game in this arena on a dunk with 1 second left. Now in overtime with 2 seconds left, he steps up, ice in his veins, knocks down the game-winning foul shot. And it's a Yellow Jackets victory to open up the college basketball season. The ACC Network, the nightcap of our doubleheader, and it lived up to the hype in a big way. Georgia Tech, a dramatic victory, 82-81. Everybody, catch your breath.